Okay, so my wife's been having some major suspension issues. Car's rattling like crazy whenever it hits a bump. We know there's a suspension problem, and what I wanted to go over today was some general different tests that you can do to check and see what exactly is wrong with a front suspension issue. You know, there's a lot of indicators when you're driving. If the car tends to like steer to the left or the right when you're accelerating, it's possibly a bearing. If the car wants to swerve to the right or the left when you hit a bump or a dip in the highway, then that means it's a ball joint. Those things all help. A lot of times clunks and clanks when you are driving and you hit a pothole, a lot of times those are the sway bar linkages. But in this case, actually, it wasn't the case. Or that wasn't what ended up happening. But I'm just going to go through a couple of the tests that happen. First off, I jack the vehicle up. I'm going to take the wheel here. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take it and I'm going to rock it back and forth vertically. These nuts aren't very tight. So I'm going to take it and I'm going to rock it back and forth this way. Okay? I'm going to go back and forth like this. And if it moves considerably, what that is an indicator of is that your ball joint is going. And what you can oftentimes do is get down on the ground and look up, and as you shake it, you'll see the steering knuckle will move back and forth and you can see the ball joint actually wiggling. That's not good. That means the ball joint shot. The next thing you can do is take the wheel like this and you're gonna shake it this way. Now, it will move a little bit no matter what, because oftentimes because of the steering linkage. If the steering linkage is moving with the wheel, then you're fine. If it's not, if the steering linkage isn't moving and the wheel is still rattling, then that's a good indicator that your bearing is shot. And so you want to make sure that you're looking at that and you check that. And the good indicator is if the wheel is moving side to side and rattling around, but the steering knuckle isn't moving, then it's definitely a bearing. And if I do this and I shake it side to side, you can see the strut is actually moving with the wheel. And so that means my bearing's pretty tight. So those are the first two real basic tests. You take the wheel and you shake it back and forth like this, and then you shake it back and forth like this. One really quick thing as a bus passes my house, I want to say is whenever you're shaking this thing, always make sure you've got the car up on jack stands. That's really important. You're going to be shaking the car, you're going to be shaking the chassis, and if the car is just on a jack, you could tip the jack over or whatever and then it could fall on you, especially when you get your hands like this, one on the bottom and one on the top. That's a really bad place for your hands. You totally don't want to have the car on just a jack. Always, always, always work on jack stands. Always make sure you're in a secure place with a good driveway that's level. Mine's actually tilted downhill a little bit here, but I've done this a lot and I'm pretty secure on this. So that looks pretty good. Next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the wheel off and I'll show you a couple of the checks that we can do on some of the components back behind here to make sure that some other things aren't bad, like the sway bar linkages, the tie rod ends, and the drive shafts. So now that the wheel's off, what we're gonna do is we're gonna check three major things. First is our tie rod ends, which are right here, or no, sorry. Sway bar ends. These are the sway bar link ends. And these tie the sway bar, which is this piece of metal which goes all the way over to the other side of the wheel. And that kind of keeps the two wheels tied together in a way that makes the car more stable. And they have these ball and socket joints here up in the top and the bottom. And those go really bad. So we're gonna check the sway bar linkage, and we're gonna check the outer tie rod ball joint, or actually just the whole tie rod, and you can kind of see if that's going bad. And actually this is a good place to also illustrate. When I took the wheel and I was shaking it side to side, I said it will move a little bit, but the issue is whether or not it moves on its own. You can also do that same test with the wheel off, okay, and just the have the brake rotor on by twisting a couple lug nuts right on to the right up and snug them right up against the brake rotor, so that's not going to go anywhere. And then I could try and do the same thing, and you can see that's really solid. And if I grab the brake rotor here and I go side to side, you can see that as I move it, you can see that the whole steering knuckle, the strut, and the tie rod end, they're moving together. So That's not something else. The caliper's wiggling, obviously, but when I move this back and forth, there's no slop, and there's no slop in here either, which is another indicator of the tie rod end being worn. So that's pretty good. So one of the things you can do, I mean, it's actually really simple to do this, to check these, is you just take them and you shake. See, that's rattling a little bit. So it's starting to get a little loose and it feels like it's this bottom one. So that might be the source of one of my rattles, and I'm pretty sure it is, and I'm gonna have to switch out both sides of that. But it's not too bad either. If it's really bad, it'll rattle around inside the socket really obviously. And these aren't critical. Cars didn't have sway bars for years. They were high-end options for a long time. Even when I was a kid, having front sway bars and rear sway bars were a really big deal. In fact, my 1970 Barracuda does not have sway bars. So it's not critical, but it does make the car handle a lot better and it does make it a lot more safe. So having the sway bar linkages on your car and having them good and solid is a really important thing, and they're cheap. They're like 40 bucks for a pair, maybe 50 bucks for a pair. So they're it's a pretty easy repair as long as you don't have too much rust, which these are pretty rusted, but maybe that'll be another YouTube video. The other thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna take this. Now, you can shake it laterally, back and forth, this way to the car, and it should stay pretty solid, okay? And then you also can get on your back and shake it along the drive axis of the car. So if I do that really quickly, and it shouldn't rattle at all. It shouldn't move up or down or side to side in any way, shape, or form. So that can see that the tie rod is really solid. So the tie rod's good on this car as well. The last check that we're gonna do that can be suspension related, well actually there's two, and I'll show you what the problem really was on my car, which is gonna be nothing that we've tested. But the next thing that we're gonna do is the drive shaft. The drive shaft can go bad really easily. And usually what happens when the drive shaft goes bad, a really good indicator of that when you're driving, is when you're turning the wheel and you're accelerating out of a stop sign or something like that, you hear clicking. Click, 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 click. And when that happens, you know your drive shafts are done. But I'm gonna get down, bring the camera down a little lower so you can see me test the drive shaft a little better. So now we're gonna test this drive shaft. Now let me say a couple things about testing the drive shaft. First off, it will oftentimes move laterally side to side, and that's normal. The drive shafts will have a lot of expansion in the joints. They're kind of designed that way from what I understand. So that's normal. What you don't want to see is you don't want to see any movement along the long axis of the car, the drive axis, this way or up and down. And so a good way to test that, just get on your back and you just grab the drive axle and you give it a good shake. And it shouldn't move at all. And if the drive axle doesn't move at all this way or this way, then you're fine. If it moves this way a little bit, like I said, that's pretty normal. When the joints inside the drive axle get really bad, you know it because it goes up and down or side to side really bad. And like I said, you oftentimes will hear the clicking before you anything else. You'll hear the clicking in the drive shaft when you turn the wheel. And that's because what's happening is when the wheel's turned, like this inner joint on the drive shaft is under a lot of pressure, and if it's going in there because there's not enough grease or anything like that, it'll start to click and give you a really good indicator. So anyway, the question becomes, why is my wife's car clicking, or not clicking, but you know, making a awful rattling sound and losing handling when we ever hit bumps? I've gone through all the checks. Bearings look good. The ball joint is fine. The control or the sway bar link ends are a little bit off, but not enough for what I'm hearing. And I know my tie rod ends are good. So the question is, what is causing the problem? And the answer is the only thing that you really can't shake to actually get a good reading on, and that is the control arm. So let me get the camera over to the side here and I'm gonna show you what the problem is. And if you've gone through all these tests and you're still hearing an awful clatter in the suspension, chances are it's the control arm bushings. And let me show you what I mean. So this bushing here is the bushing for the control arm. And you can pretty much see from this angle, and I'm gonna get a little closer in a second here, pretty much see it shot. See how the bushing is split. In fact, from my angle down here on the ground, I can see even better I can see that it's totally like, it's split out, the core is coming out of the bushing, everything. So this thing is just shot. So we're gonna replace the control arms and see if it makes much of a difference. And I already know because I replaced the other side already and took it for a drive. It made a huge difference. So this, doing the other side here, doing this side and finishing the job, I know the car is gonna basically handle like new. So that's my first job. Let's get a little bit of a closer look here. Okay, so with this better angle, hopefully you can really see how split and how wrecked this bushing is. And this is just a really good indicator of what happens. These bushings, let's see, we bought this car with 65,000 miles on it. It's got 165,000 miles on it now. So that means these bushings have at least 100,000 miles on them. It is potentially possible that they are the original control arms on the car, which means that these bushings have 160,000 miles on them. Okay, so yeah, you can just see how this thing is shot really bad. You can just see how the bushing is separating from the center core. I mean, it's all cracked and stuff, and rubber cracks pretty easily and gets cracked, you know, really quickly. When you put a new control arm in, you'll see the rubber cracking. But this, I mean, you can see if I just push on this thing, you can see the core moving inside the rubber, and I can wiggle it around really easily, and that's just not good. It's not that safe. The ride quality was really bad. So that sort of stuff, I mean, look, I should not be able to peel that away from the center, the core. So that's just really bad. And it just wasn't worth it to buy a new bushing and then try to replace it, because I knew that this ball joint had a lot of mileage on it. And if you take a look, the ball joint's not, you can't pull the ball joint out of the control arm. So unlike some of the older cars, like my old 91 Honda that I used to have, I could replace the ball joints without replacing the whole control arm. But in this case, I have to replace everything together. And you know what, it's worth it. I mean, a new ball joint's usually 50 or 60 bucks. New bushings are $45 a piece. So just say that's about $150 to $170 for the whole, for the ball joint and two bushings. And I got the top end Moog. So I didn't get the full Honda, but I got the top end Moog control arm for $175. So, you know, it's worth it, and it'll definitely make the repair a lot better. So hopefully this video has helped you. Hopefully you've learned a little bit about some suspension tests that you can do, especially for the home mechanic. As I was saying, the lesson learned for me here on this one is that once I did all of the checks and the tests, everything was testing out fine, and yet there were still massive rattles whenever I hit a bump. The only thing I could think of was the control arms and these bushings, and sure enough, they're pretty bad. But that's okay. The suspension will be nice and tight, and things will feel really good, and you know, it'll be perfect for summertime. Thanks for watching, and if you want more of these videos, click subscribe. It really helped me out. Thanks.